Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. Today we have a question from Dan in Akron. If you have a question, plenty of ways to get it in. Email it, send it in as a voicemail, Skype, however you want to do it. Dan's question is pretty interesting. He has a chart in Excel. It's charting four people. And when someone new gets added to the department, Dan adds a new column into the middle of the chart. And this isn't a matter of how to add the data. Dan is frustrated that when he adds the column, Excel automatically extends the size of the chart. So let me just come here and do insert column, and all of a sudden, now the width of the chart has increased. He doesn't want the size of his charts to increase at all. So let me remove that column. Now normally, when we have some sort of an object in Excel, you can right-click the object, choose format, and on the properties tab, say that you don't want to move in size with cells. But when we right-click the chart, we just get to format chart area, which allows us to change the color of the chart area, not the properties. Well, it turns out, if you think back to the days of Lotus 1, 2, 3, all new charts were always created as their own chart sheets. And going back to the early days of Excel, that's the way it worked. But at some point, there was a split, and Excel said, well, we're going to let you put a chart embedded right on the current sheet. And even though it looks like the chart is on the sheet, it turns out that the chart is actually in a chart container. And it's the chart container that we need to get to in order to access the chart. It's completely unintuitive, but what you have to do is you have to control click on the chart. You'll notice that instead of having the black handles that I had at the beginning of the podcast, I now have white handles at each side. Now when I right click, I have a completely different menu, including format object. Inside format object, I can get to the properties tab where I can say, don't move or size with cells. Click OK. Now when I insert a new column, the chart stays the exact same width that it was before. Thanks to Dan, that was a great question. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.